Nationals MP Keith Pitt. Keith, it's always great to see you. How are you, mate?
Fantastic. It's always good to be back in Canberra unexpectedly.
There you go. Bet you're enjoying it to the hilt. Now, these four challenges that have been identified, I want to get your thoughts on how close to the mark they are. One, of course, is the economy. So both here and abroad, what do you think on the way our economic leaders are taking us, Keith?
Well, it was only a couple of weeks ago that we saw Federal Labor here celebrating the fact inflation didn't get over 7%. It was 6.8 or 9. I mean, really? Australia's got an incredibly resilient economy, but a big chunk of that does come from the resources sector, and it's forecast to break all records, $450 billion this financial year. But I can tell you what will happen if the Greens continue to get their way, which is what we're seeing in the current Labor government. They're in all sorts of strife. They want to run them out of town. And we look at what's happening in the rest of the world. I mean, I was in Germany. They've put up a $200 billion subsidy for the cost of electricity and gas because the costs have quadrupled. No one can afford to pay them. And guess what? Intermittent wind and solar doesn't cut the mustard.
And Keith, what do you think of Chalmers' management of our economy in cahoots with Chris Bowen, with his bizarre energy fantasies?
Well, the Treasurer just a few short weeks ago at budget time said that there'll be no big giant cash splash with borrowed money because it would be disastrous for the economy and terrible for inflation. And that lasted a handful of days. It's now a good thing and everybody gets a check. Well, not everybody gets a check. Some Australians will get some support. We yet to find out who and how it happens in each state and how that might work. But I'll guarantee you the premiers are getting a bucket load of cash. And it just doesn't work. It hasn't worked anywhere else in the world. It creates enormous challenges in terms of trying to keep the network stable, functional and not blacked out. And we now see that they're running towards this even faster. I mean, the decision on the capacity mechanism, you're now going to subsidise intermittent wind and solar or other intermittent products because apparently if you pay them more, they become reliable.
Yeah, exactly. Now, Keith, one of the other things Tom Switzer pointed to was the actual collapse of Western values, the Judeo-Christian principles we're all brought up in, this our entire civilization is founded on, the history that has shaped us, the family unit. These socialists and left-wingers are seeking to undermine what has been a truly successful and incredible society. Does that bother you?
Oh, I'm incredibly concerned and have been for some time. And a lot of this comes back to our education system. We want our kids to be taught how to think, not what to think. And we're not getting that in Australia, unfortunately. And it's getting worse. I mean, you don't have to be a person of faith to support those Judeo-Christian methods, policies, processes. Just that general approach to how we manage our society is actually good for all of us. And yet we see socialism slash communism making a comeback. As the great lady once said, socialism's great till you run out of other people's money.
Exactly. Now, the third thing Tom points to is the absolute climate zealotry. Absolutely agree with him there. The self-loathing renewables religion that pours fire on the economy and ironically is being manipulated, as I mentioned earlier in the show, by very, very wealthy funds and business tycoons who are all in it and up to the eyeballs with renewables. How dangerous is this climate zealotry, in your opinion?
Well, I've never been one to kneel at the altar, and that's caused me some grief in the past. I clearly remember an interviewer saying, what do you mean you won't repeat the words I just gave to you? Like it's some terrible sin. But the real danger is to our economy. The way that Labor are moving, and they're moving far more rapidly than A, they should, and B, they need to. And that will make the economy entirely reliant on the weather. You've only got to ask any farmer how difficult that is. At a time when we need our nation to be at its absolute strongest, Chris Bowen and Federal Labor are going to have electricity generators which are 95% reliant on China for purchase and replacement. It's not in our interest. It shouldn't be done. We should be sweating our coal assets as long as possible and do what Britain and others have committed to recently, and that is get nuclear into Australia. It is safe, it is green, it is reliable, and it works.
And finally, Keith, just quickly before we go, Switzer points to the geopolitical situation, the instability around the world, China, Russia, etc., and a weak Joe Biden in America. Your thoughts?
Yeah, well, the US has clearly changed their force posture, and that is shifting the world order, which is creating significant challenges. I was at NATO, the assembly, a couple of weeks ago, and in a positive turn of events, they are very strong on the Ukraine, very strong and united, and they are turning their eyes to the Pacific, and that is important. We need our allies to know where those challenges are, and I think this is going to be something in the future we've got to be very cautious with. And I come back to the point I made earlier. We need our nation to be stronger, and that includes our national energy network.
Keith Pitt, thanks so much. I've really enjoyed having you on this show during the last 6 months. It's been fantastic. You're an absolute, boon to our nation. Keep up the great work, Keith Pitt, and have a very Merry Christmas. Thanks.